the legend of Billy Archer. Even how Billy Archer was young once, I know it's hard to believe, it's one of the things getting about that's difficult to conceive. He was born in Port by Road, you know, where Irish settlers met their own, in the days when money was tight and the outlook for work was good. These folk born of Archer and Graff warmed their one at one down as McCookshick Archer towed the fence in Monway's business climate. Through New World Thirties Council Estates, the young Billy gained social awareness. They learned to knock into bread and jam and live through community kindness. He was schooled over on King's Hill, watched films, tears the altar. He got entertained at Penny Rush when he needed a place to go. Then a fourth outbreak of war, he moved out onto Pride Park, got signed up to the armed forces, and a deal they conscripted his mark. All for a band of Ricky Fire and the Enfields at that Bearer campaign, got numbers built up rugby with his working class dignity to retain. He then met his missus out of Wednesbury Works while he still served in the Royal Marines, got married when he was 19 to Frieda, the woman of his dreams. And after the war was done and dusted, Bill took to long distance lorry driving, sang songs on the variety circuit. For success he was always a striver. Could have gone on to London's media service, but he chose his family instead. Decided to get into politics, a shop steward in blue and not red. Then Bill went into local retail selling, spoke up at the market move, supported local people when they thought they got something to prove. He got enacted at the third attempt, standing up in his birthright town that lies in the court of Sandwell, before for Wednesbury like one town. His name was heard in press and chamber in living rooms and pubs, along with his fine singing voice in the Conservative and Legion clubs. This bloke was at his good times, and suffered heartache on the way. But from his strong personal beliefs, his mind would never stray. A democratic socialist in nature, serving the public for many a year, before he was given the honour of being a metropolitan mayor. So in his devoted daughter Elaine went on to serve folk well enough, raising record funds for charities with walks and auctions and stuff. And now our Bill has served his days and gone on to pastures new. He'll be sadly missed, you know, with a many and not a few. And so the legend of Billy Archer continues to this very day. And long may his legacy continue, because he always had something to say.